Bonjour, on va reprendre cet après-midi de conférence en commençant par une démo de 15 minutes qui va vous être proposée par Mateusz Zalewski. Donc, en effet, aujourd'hui, on a plein de conférenciers qui viennent partager leur savoir avec nous, mais les sponsors également ont des choses à nous apprendre. Et Mateusz va nous parler de Silius, dont on a déjà pas mal entendu parler depuis ce matin. Mateusz, please, let's give us your knowledge.
Hi, everyone. And I'm really, really happy I can be here. And thank you very much for the introduction. And I must say that you pronounced my surname pretty well. Thank you very much for that. Generally, I'm really happy that I can present you at least a little bit something about Silius because, 15 minutes of presentation is, of course, not everything that I would like to have. As you can imagine, I can talk about Silius for ages, but I hope that in this really quick time, I will be able to at least share a little bit of knowledge about Silius with you. And the idea of this presentation is to answer the question from the topic, what is Silius and why you should know it? So of course, the short answer is Silius is an e-commerce platform based on Symfony. But of course, it does not fulfill the subject, yes, so because there's plenty of things that we focus on in Silius, and there's plenty of things that we would like to do a little bit different than other e-commerce platforms, and plenty of things that for you as mainly technical people, mainly developers, can be attracted to and that you can like. Okay, so the most important advantage and difference between Silius and other e-commerce platforms is that we are not trying to do everything for e-commerce and everything that you can need in your application. Why? From our experience, but not only our experience, the experience of our clients, partners, people from our community, because Silius, as you probably know, I hope so, is open source platform, so we have a really big community. We see that there is plenty of things that is common in e-commerce platforms, in the e-commerce shops. Definitely more like this 80s, maybe 85% of things are generally the same. But at the end, we still have this 15 or 20% of some custom business needs that every e-commerce platform will need. I mean, every mature e-commerce platform, because of course, we are not talking about shops like selling only 4 books about me and my dog. It's nothing bad. It's good that you would like to do it, but maybe this is not the best choose to use Silius for such a thing. That's why we decided that we would like to be focused on this e-commerce, into e-commerce functionalities and make it as easy to integrate as possible with some other platform that provides another specialized functionalities that you can need in your system. But going from the beginning about Silius, we have always been thinking about the developer experience. And Silius, from the very beginning, were focused on the really high developer experience. I really care a lot about developer productivity. That's why from the very beginning of our history, of Silius history, we are working with the test-driven development and behavior-driven development. We are caring a lot about clean code and coding standards. And I hope you will be sure from what I'm saying that these are not just slogans. We are really doing it, and we are really caring a lot about testing and about coding standards and clean code and BDD and TDD. And we are really using it in our everyday work. And when we develop Silius and when we extend Silius with new functionalities. And this is also one of the reasons why sometimes you can be a little bit scared when you start to work with Silius as a developer, because there is so many tests around BHAT scenarios and unit tests. But at the end, we see from our developers, from developers that work with Silius in the core team, but also from the developers that work in the community, that this really improves improves the developer experience, but in the same time, it also benefits in a really, really big benefits regarding the business features. Because when we go with this test-driven development or behavior-driven development flow, when you care about the clean code and coding standards, the longer you develop the project, the nicer it gets, I would say. I think this is the opposite from the from what we regularly expect from the project, because this is at the beginning we are in hype, and at the end we are just want to move to the another project. But yes, but generally, of course, it's not always perfect, but generally we are heading to such a perfect scenario when you just want to work with the project that you develop with Celius. I have been talking a little bit about this easiness of integration, and this is one of the core things that we are focusing right now in Celius, during the development of Celius. We just don't want to make the perfect e-commerce system and in the same time the perfect product management system, a loyalty system, and ERP system, CMS. We don't know to do it, because at the same time we know that this is just not possible. There are plenty of projects, at least in the PHP ecosystem, in the Symfony ecosystem, but not only, that fulfills these needs that you can have from your from this part of your system much better than we could ever do, because we just want to focus on the e-commerce stuff. So in the same time when we focus on the e-commerce parts of the system of Celius, we want to make it as easy to possible as to integrate with some other system, with some product management system like Akeneo or Pimcore, with some ERP system, other CMS systems, etc., to make it as easy for you, for developers, and also as easy for business, because at the end, all these values, like this outside value and inside value of the system, of the really mature system, need to be fulfilled. We also, because we care a lot about this testing experience and this test-driven approach, we also, when you develop Celius, you can have really fast feedback from what you would like to change in the Celius. For example, when you open the pull request, you can have a really fast feedback regarding, did you break anything, because we have plenty of scenarios, and did you make something better? And this is also a really important thing for us. There was a time when we have this Travis CI build that lasts for 2 hours, and it was way too long, but right now it's below 30 minutes, and it's really acceptable, and you can really fast get the feedback about, did your change broke anything, and did your change make anything better? And this is really great, because you just don't have to test anything on the production, just going with the slogan. And of, as maybe some of you already know, is that Celius is not only the e-commerce platform, you can also use it with separate bundles and separate components. This is a really nice system, because when you care about, when you want to have some product related functionality in your system, you don't have to download or require the whole Celius. You can just get the Celius product component when you have just plain PHP classes that focuses around the concept of product. And then you can have another level higher, you can have the product bundle, which gives you the integration between this product component and Symfony. And because we are basic on Symfony for so long time, we really try to be as close to Symfony as possible. And I hope we are doing it quite well. Of course, we can talk a little bit about that on our Celius booth. And at the top, we have this Celius platform, which is the usual way of using Celius, but not the only way that you can do it. So you don't, in fact, you don't need to be a Celius developer if you would like to start working with Celius. This is one of the, I would say, one of the biggest advantage also from the like human resources point of view. If you are working with Celius, you don't need to hire the Celius developer. If you already have the Symfony developer, probably he will be able to start to work, he or she will be able to start with to work with Celius quite quickly. And even if you only have the PHP developers, because of our high quality of code and really, really big, really important approach to the coding standards and testing testing functionalities, working with Celsius, even if the entry level can seem to be quite high, at the end it's really a big fun, and it is something that we always hear from the community, that just working with Celsius from the technical point of view is fun. And this is great, because this is one of the things that we want to achieve. We wanted and we still want to create an e-commerce platform that in the same time will be providing and resolving the business needs of business, and in the same time will be just fun to work with and fun to develop for the developers. It was, of course, really, really quick. If you would like to talk a little bit more about Celsius, I can invite you to our Celsius booth, because we are one of the, as you know, we are one of the sponsors of this event. You can ping me on GitHub or on Twitter. I already see that there are plenty of familiar, maybe not faces, but names and nicknames on the chat. So a lot of people from our community. Yes, Oliver, this is one of you are one of the people from the Celsius community. Yes, so there are plenty of people that would like also to share their knowledge about Celsius, not only me. So I hope that you like this really quick presentation. I see that there are some questions. And I will try to answer at least some of them. Yeah, and at the end, thank you very much for your patience and for your attendance. Okay, so I think that I will finish the presentation right now, and we'll go to the at least one question. Okay, so the highest question, as I see here, is. Yes, can I answer already on the question?
Please answer some question. And if you don't have time to answer to all of them, I'll keep the room open and you can write your answer under the questions in the...
Okay, so I'll start with this one. Is there any crowdfunding system built in or any plugin to create crowdfunding platforms at Kickstarter, like Kickstarter, for instance? As far as I know, no. I believe that it would be a nice challenge to implement something like this for Celsius, because I have not mentioned that, but we already have plenty of plugins that extend the Celsius functionality or integrate it with some platforms. But as far as I know, I have never seen anything like integration or the built-in crowdfunding platform for Celsius. But it does not mean anything, because I can just be not aware about that, because Celsius is the open source solution, we already know that there are plenty of plugins and integrations in the world which we are not even aware of, but it's just the magic of open source that plenty of people are doing the plenty of things that we don't even have to know about. So the short answer is no. Okay, so this one is I'm done answering. Okay. Are there plans concerning B2B functionalities in Celsius? Okay, so right now we are not focusing on the B2B functionalities, because we are focusing on extending the B2C functionalities that we have in Celsius right now. And we are also focusing on extending the Celsius Plus version, the paid version of Celsius, with more enterprise functionalities for our open source solution. As far as I know, some of our partners have already developed some kind of the B2B suits or B2B toolboxes for Celsius. So you can also take a look at our on the plugin list, and you can take a look at the projects that our partners do. But perfectly honest, right now we are not thinking about improving or developing anything regarding the B2B in Celsius. It can change, but I don't know. Right now, we are not planning to do that. Okay, and I think that I'll have the time for one more question.
Last question. Okay.
How is it to have dropshipping in Celsius, meaning that Celsius place an order on a printing partner to send the product directly to the client? Okay, so this is really tricky question, because if you depends what do you mean by easy, because I can imagine that really quick and really basic dropshipping functionality can be done by an experienced developer in a day or two. Really basic, But I can imagine that I could do that. But if you are talking about some really mature dropshipping system that should take care about a billion of cases that we don't even can think about right now, it would be definitely much, much harder and much longer to implement that. But I would say it's definitely something that you can do with the skills of the experienced developers in the reasonable amount of time. But I would love to talk about a little bit more about that, but we don't have a time for that. Good question, but not something that I can really answer in detail in such a short amount of time. So sorry for that. So it can be quite easy, but usually it will not be easy. Okay, so that was the last question. Sorry that I have not been able to answer for all of them. I see that there are two more, so I'll try just to answer them and after the talk. Thank you very much one more time.
Thanks a lot, and please, if you have some more questions, go to Silius' booth, and I'm pretty sure they will have some time to answer face-to-face, well, through the camera, of course, but, well, they'll be here today and tomorrow for you. Okay. Merci à tout le monde. Bye,
Mathieu. Bye.
On continue cet après-midi de conférence. On va vous envoyer dans un instant un call to action vers la prochaine conférence qui se tiendra dans la salle Johnson. Et si jamais vous êtes intéressé par la conférence de la salle Hopper, je vous invite à retrouver votre convocation avec les liens de l'après-midi. Bon après-midi tout le monde.